A guide to evaluating the currency of information. Hello, language learners. Welcome to another video in our English language learning series. Today, we are delving into the fascinating topic of evaluating the currency of information. This is a critical skill, especially when you are researching or learning new things. It's essential to ensure that the information you're using is not only accurate but also up to date. So, let's get started. The first thing we need to understand is why the currency of information is important. Currency refers to how recent the information is. In a rapidly changing world, outdated information can be misleading or incorrect. Whether you're writing a research paper, studying for an exam, or just learning something new, it's important to use the most recent and relevant information available. One of the easiest ways to check the currency of information is by identifying the date of publication. This date tells you when the information was last updated. But remember, the relevance of the date may depend on the topic. For example, a 10-year-old article about fashion trends might not be very useful now, but a 10-year-old research paper on Shakespeare's plays might still be relevant. Another method to evaluate the currency of information is checking for updates or revisions. If an article or a study has been updated or revised, it means the author has added new information or made changes to the existing content. Look for terms like updated, revised, or edition to determine if the content has been refreshed. Finally, you can look at the references used in the source. If the references are recent, that suggests the author has used up-to-date sources and therefore the content might be current as well. However, if the references are quite old, that might be a sign that the information could be outdated. And there we go. That's a brief guide to evaluating the currency of information. Remember, the most reliable information is often the most current. So always take the time to check the dates, updates, and references. As always, we hope this video was helpful and can't wait to see you in the next one. Keep learning, keep growing, and stay curious.